Jean-René Mounié, top coach, it's your day, three Brazilians through to the semi-finals of the men's event here in Santo, Domingo. First of all was Cazuo Matsumoto, who plays Felipe Olivares from Chile. Olivares, young player, hungry for success. It's 2-2. First four games of the fight took before Cazuo took control to win 4-2. So Cazuo Matsumoto, you must be pleased with it.
Yeah, it was a tough match, but we knew before. You know, in Latin America, everybody used to play many times again. Then finally, the level is quite different than if you play international tournament in Europe or in Asia. It's totally different. You can see, for example, against Tabas, it was a really tough match. He takes too much points. And every time we know, because when you go, okay, I'm not saying if we play 10 times, then GK will win. But I mean, when the difference of level is less important, at the end maybe level is a little bit more similar. Then I think they believe a lot they can win against Cazuo, and it's normal. Cazuo has a half start, but step by step he played better and better, and after he found good solution for winning more easy.
Well, we all take a deep breath at his performance in Guangzhou. When he lost to Bastian State the first match of the World Team Classic, then he didn't lose the match. He finished beating Jean-René Cazuo, number 9 in the world, 3-0. Now, is there anything you could identify as to why the year 2013 is so proud as the year of Cazuo Matsumoto?
Yeah, that's true. I think it was a surprise because he's playing good because he won in Spain before. He's playing better and better, but of course in Guangzhou he's a fantastic leader. What is really interesting is we know this is not his normal leader, the great leader, but when you succeed once, you can think you can make one more time, and then now we have to work in this way and you need to be really regular and let's see the future. Yeah,
the man of the moment, isn't he? Now, next on court is Thiago Monteiro. He has to play Jose Miguel Ramirez. Now, Jose Miguel Ramirez, earlier this year, beating Marcelo Aguirre, the Latin American champion for El Salvador. He beats him something like 12-10 in the seventh game. You win a close match, you believe it's your day, but Thiago rather sees control to win 4-1.
We have to say first that it was, I cannot say lucky, but it was quite good to win because every time Jose was had 2-3 points before Thiago, and he had 2 lucky points at the end, but he captured his opportunity, and after I think he had the match under control. He served okay, first attack was quite good, and I think he played really good to deliver today.
Well, of course, Thiago is a defending champion. He won in Costa Rica last year, and maybe that was the sign. Thiago coming back to form, having been injured for maybe 1 or 2 years with his wrist injury. So the wrist is standing up now, there's no problems with his physical shape?
Yeah, he has to manage because he has still sometimes pain in his hand. But I think now he can practice in a good way. Very interesting for him. I think also he needs to not to think, okay, how he can play before he's injured, but now he has only to practice hard and to play in different matches. I think step by step is improving a lot, and I hope for him he can continue this way. Not for Cazuo, but for him.
Just to illustrate that point, the semi-final is Cazuo Matsumoto versus Thiago Monteiro, so you've got to go to the stand and just be a spectator.
Yeah,
but of course, you'll be very much involved with Gustavo Tsuboi. He will play tomorrow in June. Now, Gustavo, today, he finished the day in Castro Alto. Powerful player. Well, I'm watching Gustavo play now. I'm not watching Michael Appleton play. He's back on the table, tossing him. I'm watching Jack Sefretano. Are you French? Is that your influence?
Yeah, no, to be honest, no. And I think the key was more about this missing first attack. I think when the game is really open, you have some really dangerous players. But I think Gustavo managed and succeed to serve well, to receive well. And then after it was much more difficult for Gaston to organize the game at the night. And I think Gustavo has really good focus, and then he can fix it today.
Well, all three players, Jean-René, they all looking well prepared. They all succeeded. None needed a seventh game. I mean, there was no drama in these quarterfinals. To you, the coach, Jean-René, congratulations. Congratulations to the